So my poverty comes is one that traveled, and my want is an odd man. So here the Bible is talking about the lazy person, that they do a lot of sleeping, and a lot of slumbering, and a lot of folding of the hands to sleep. Now, if you think about this, obviously sleep is good for you. Sleep is a good thing. But what this makes me think of is people that are tired all the time. Now, we all get tired from time to time, right? Now, tiredness should be a result of having exerted yourself. You know, you go out and work really hard, then you're tired, okay? Or you go out and just do something that's very strenuous, as a result, you're tired. Maybe you skip a little sleep a few nights, as a result, you're tired. But then if you notice that there are people who are just tired before they've done a thing, and they're just tired all the time, and they're just, you know, that means that they're probably just lazy. And people that are lazy will often just mask it as, oh, I'm tired, I'm just really tired, I'm so tired, I just don't have any energy. Now, part of that could have to do with your diet. You know, if you're eating complete junk all the time, and we as God's people, sometimes, you know, we need to study the Bible and learn what the Bible teaches about food and nutrition. That's another sermon. I don't want to go into that. But honestly, it's true that eating a lot of junk food, eating a lot of processed foods, eating a lot of unhealthy foods can diminish your energy level. But often I think that this thing of I'm tired is just a lazy person who wants to slumber, they want to sleep, they want to fold their hands to sleep, they want to sit around, they want to do, and they drag and move slowly, and they just do that under the guise of I'm tired. But part of the reason why you're tired is because you're not doing anything. You see, ironically, people who use more energy, they end up having more energy. I mean, think about it. Anybody knows anything about exercise, right? You know, the more you run, the more energy you're going to have to run more. People who don't run at all aren't going to have any energy to run. So what I'm saying is, if you go to work and you work hard and you get up and you get moving and you do stuff, you'll end up with more energy. If you sit around on the couch all day, if you just relax all the time, if you sleep in all the time, that you think, oh yeah, I'm just really charging my batteries. I'm going to have so much. I'm going to sleep for like 12 hours. I'm going to have so much energy. I'm just going to spend a whole day just laying down. The next day, man, I'm just going to have so much energy. My batteries are going to charge, but it isn't true. It isn't true because idleness casts you into a deep sleep. You know, idleness sitting around makes you tired. It makes you sluggish, and it gives you less energy. So, yes, eat the right food, but also sometimes even when you're tired, even when you don't feel like it, you work anyway. You force yourself to get going. Even when you're tired and you don't feel like it, you push yourself. And then you're telling your body what to do. And then your body says, okay, even when I'm tired, I'm going to be forced to do what I need to do anyway. I'm just going to quit this tired game. It's true. But if you reward your body for being tired all the time, it's just going to be tired more. And so we see some attributes. All right, just from this first passage, just from this one scripture, we see that the lazy person is slow moving. They always need a supervisor or somebody to crack the whip over them. And they are lazy, they sleep, they're tired all the time, they just can't get enough rest. And it says the result in verse 11 is poverty. It says, thy poverty shall come as one that traveleth, and thy want as an armed man. What does it mean as an armed man? It's like an armed robbery. Poverty and want are going to come rob you of what you have and what you possess. You're being robbed of your money, you're being robbed of success due to laziness, the Bible says. Due to too much sleep and sluggardly, slovenly, slumber, whatever. I don't know, something else that starts with S. Anyway, go to chapter 10 of Proverbs, if you would. Chapter 10 of Proverbs. And this is a sermon that can really apply to anybody. Because, you know, we obviously, when we talk about working and supervising, we automatically think of men. But obviously, this applies to man, woman, boy, and girl, because women have different types of work that they do, but they still have work that they do. I mean, they sound like my wife, for example. It's funny, she was summoned for jury duty, and the choice is she had to click her employment status, whether she was employed, or self-employed, or unemployed. And what was that? What was the other choice? Oh, retired, you know. And she's looking at this like, well, I'm not really unemployed. I mean, I'm not trying to find a job, you know, I just told her, you know, I don't know, you're retired, I mean, you retired at age 21, you know, when you married me, that's when you retired, but she's been retired ever since she's 21. You know, you get her sticker that says retired and loving it or whatever. But anyway, the bottom line is, you know, basically, she does not have a job. But do you think that she's been just kicking out for the last 13 years, slumbering and sleeping as we married? No. She works very hard. She gets up early and stays up late. She does a different type of work, but she's still working hard. She's still expending a lot of energy. So just as men can be lazy on the job and be not sleeping on the job or not dilly-dallying on the job, you know, women can sometimes become lazy in their job. Even as a homemaker or housewife, they can become lazy with that job.
Happy birthday, Tati.
Happy
birthday.
You know,
you're 5 months old, honey.
A child is known by his doings, whether his work be pure and whether it be right. Even a child needs to listen to this sermon and understand that you shouldn't have to be supervised all the time. When mom and dad give you a job, you should be able to execute that job without constantly being supervised. But you can stay working where you don't have to just get on, whether it's, and it could be schoolwork. You know, doing your homework or your schoolwork or, you know, filling out your worksheets of learning, you know, reading, writing, arithmetic. You know, you don't want to have your parents just constantly on you, just, you know, what are you doing? You know, because you're looking around, pulling around, you know, you're not getting the chores done right. Look, start now as a child developing the habits of hard work and diligence, and then when you're an adult, you're going to succeed on the job. But you're not just going to flip a switch when you turn 16, or flip a switch when you turn 18, and you've been lazy and indigent and sitting around and doing nothing, and fooling around and daydreaming, and not being obedient when you're given a job to do, and then all of a sudden at 16, 18, you just flip a switch and you're just gonna, man, you're just gonna take the world by the tail. You know, you're just gonna go out and you're gonna make so much more.